on today's episode of The Supernatural Now.
One of the causes of unforgiveness, immaturity. Offense, let go that offense. Let go that debt. Forgive, forgive, forgive. There's so many blessings. Be in hell, in heaven, because you have not forgiven.
Jesus came to earth to teach and to demonstrate the supernatural with miracles, signs, and wonders. God doesn't change. God is supernatural. Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is called to bring God's supernatural power to this generation. For over 25 years, he has been teaching and activating believers from around the world to do the same. Get ready to receive your miracle today and allow God to use you to demonstrate His power here and now. This is a reality you can experience in your life today. Join us as we see more of the supernatural now.
The central organ of the human body is the heart. Yet we humans have another heart, a spiritual one, that is the true center of our existence. Join Apostle Maldonado on a journey of discovery into the purpose, motivation, and potential of our spiritual heart. God wants us to understand how, in Christ, our heart is designed to pump life into our entire being, producing mental, emotional, and physical health. You were created to reflect the heart of our Heavenly Father, and God is ready to change our hearts to be like His through a supernatural transformation. Call now, and for your generous donation of any amount, we'll send you a copy of this life-changing book. Also, if you become a partner today, you will receive not only this book, but also a special DVD teaching and our exclusive partner pin. This is our way of saying thank you for your continued support to the ongoing work of our ministry.
I want to welcome all the people that are watching by the internet and watching by television. Can you put your hand together and welcome them? I am teaching on unforgiveness, the power of forgiveness. There's a reconciliation, harmony, peace, health in your body when you forgive other people. So this is the time to practice what Jesus came to die for. So what are the consequences of unforgiveness? I want you to write it down. First, unforgiveness contaminates and perverts the flow of the anointing in our life. Unforgiveness contaminates and perverts the flow of the anointing in our life. Somebody that is preaching with bitterness, unforgiveness in their heart is contaminating the church. Let me put it this way. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 15. Where does that scripture says? Let me tell you this. When somebody is bitter, when somebody has unforgiveness, and you talk to that person, you immediately will be contaminated. That's the reason you cannot allow contaminated, bitter people contaminate your life. Looking carefully, lest anyone fall short of the grace of God. the grace people don't teach that. Lest any roots of bitterness springing up cause trouble. And by this, many become defiled. The word defiled, you know what it is? Contaminated. The easiest way that a person can contaminate is a person that is bitter. They contaminate you like this. It doesn't matter if it's your mother. It doesn't matter if it's your father. You say, no, no, you not contaminate me. I pray for you. I love you. But I'm not going to be a garbage can for you to poison my soul and my body. Come on. We all make mistakes. We all miss it. But we all miss it. That's the reason Jesus came to pay a price. If you miss it, if you fail, go back to the cross. Jesus, I missed it. I failed. I repent in the name of Jesus. So do not allow contamination, even if your own family member, you say no. Because the Bible says many will become defiled, contaminated. A person that is bitter, that has unforgiveness, easy. Just say this, and you contaminate. Say, oh my God. And it poisons your spirit, your ears, your soul. Why contaminates your spirit, your soul, your body, the unforgiveness? Because anybody with unforgiveness, bitterness, offense, listen to me and write it down. You will not be able to retain anything that is imparted to you. I have seen people with unforgiveness. I lay hands on them, release the blessing of God, the impartation, the power, the presence of God. And 1 minute later, they came out, they leak. They couldn't retain any blessing. Why? Because of the heart. That's why many people don't understand. They come to church and they come to church. Oh my God, in Jesus' name. But you never change. You never retain the blessing. You can't keep the blessing. My purpose as a pastor, as an apostle, is to keep you in the blessing. When preachers come here, they bless you. But my purpose as your papa is to keep you in the blessing. So, but you can retain activation, impartation, the power, the presence, if you have unforgiveness. Joseph was thrown unjustly. That's the key. That's what the devil said. That was unjust. You don't deserve that. And you think, because it was unjustly done to me, I have the right not to forgive. Amen. Joseph was thrown into prison. That's right. Oh, my God. And being in there, Genesis chapter 39, verse 2, and then being in the prison, Joseph, what happened with Joseph? His brothers sold him out for 20 pesos. Sold him out. Because one time he was sharing with his brothers the vision of God. Usually when you're a visionary and share what God has given you, people will sell you. People will say, "Where do you think he's from? What do you think he at?" Because they do not believe what God has given you. So they got jealous of his brother, and they said, "We're going to sell him out." And they sold it for 20 pesos. Say, "Do you have anybody here to sell?" "No," he said, "no animals. I'm going to sell my brother. 20 pesos. Could you forgive your brother if he sells you for 20 pesos? Like my son said over there, "I'm going to leave the gospel for 20 minutes, and I'm going to get a machine gun." Don't do that. So he said, the Lord was with Joseph, and he was a successful man. What is being successful according to God? Not according to the world. According to the world is to have money and power and prestige. According to God is to be doing what he called you to do. Amen. So, and then he was in the house of his master, the Egyptian. And then you will see in chapter 45, verse 4. What did I tell you? That when you forgive, it's when God releases you from your prison. And then he said, please. And then Joseph said to his brother, the brothers, they're hungry. There's a famine in the land. And they sold them many years ago. They never thought they were going to find this brother. And the brother now is the prime minister of Egypt. What about that? Oh, my God. And the guy is on a throne. He's the prime minister. And they said, people from Israel were coming into Egypt to get food. And Joseph saw his brother. And everybody said, give me food. And Joseph could have said, let me kill them all. And then he said, please come near to me. They didn't know it was Joseph, his brother. So they came near, and then he said, I am Joseph. I am the one you stole that $20,000. I am the one that you spoke badly of me. I am the one that you were saying a lot of garbage about me without hearing me. We'll see. Okay. I am Joseph, your brother, who you sold into Egypt. Oh, what a pain. And what does it say, Pastor? The moment he forgave them, the moment he forgave them, he said that he cried like a baby. He said, you betrayed me, you sold me, and I forgive you. And he said, and the Lord make me forget. Come on, what God, what kind of God was there? The moment he forgave, God promoted Joseph into the palace. Joseph came out of the prison. What prison are you in today? Spiritual, emotional, mental, physical. What prison are you here today because of your forgiveness? The moment you forgive, God remove you from it. God will remove you from the debt. The moment you forgive others, God will cancel all your physical, all your sickness, all your financial debts. God will cancel them. The moment you forgive, God will accelerate that business. The moment you forgive, God will accelerate your purpose because he will take you out. He got the power. He got the anointing. He got the glory to get you out of the prison. God is restoring. God wants to bring peace into your home. God wants to bring prosperity. But do not let contamination poison your body, poison your soul, poison your children. Don't wait. Don't look for a perfect church. There's no such a thing as perfect church. There's no such a thing because we're all working. We're being worked. We're being changed. We're being transformed. You need to mature. What are the causes of unforgiveness? Immaturity. Offense. Let go that offense. Let go that debt. Forgive. 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 There's so many blessings. Be in hell, in heaven, because you have not forgiving. Oh, Jesus. Can I hear an amen, guys? Unforgiveness blocks the hand of God to bring justice and reconciliation. Do you want God to do justice with what they did to you? God is blocked. He can't do anything because it's against his word. To do you justice as you are bitter. Until you forgive, that is the moment that he said, the vengeance is mine. Release me, because it's against my word. If I do justice to you, they stole money, they spoke bad about you, they did something unjustly, that's not right, and I want to defend you, but I can't until you forgive. Come on, put your hand together. Until you forgive, put your hand together, come on. God, you must forgive. When you forgive, peace, shalom, reconciliation, life, health is coming back into your body. It's about time. The body of Christ, the church, you, come back and say, come on, Jesus, die for me. Say something. I say something. Jesus, die for me. I must forgive. The moment you forgive, he will make that man, touch that man to pay the money that he owes you. The moment you forgive, he will jump in and will say, wait a minute, I'm God. I will fight for you. The house you are losing because you were unjustly fair treated and they use you. Now I'm going to fight until you forgive. Forgive your boss. Forgive your jefe. Forgive your pastor. Forgive your mentor. God will not going to deal with you until you forgive. Unforgiveness will bring you into judgment and condemnation. Matthew chapter 5, verse 22. If you ask today, let's get start singing. If you ask today any church in America and you ask them, do you believe unforgiveness is a sin that takes you to hell? They will say no. Because they put sin in scales. Yes, it's a sin to steal. Yeah, it's a great sin to commit adultery. And all those are sins. I'm not saying not. But I'm saying this is the highest sin in the kingdom of God. This is the highest transgression. And this is what he said. But I said to you, judgment and condemnation. And then he said, I said to you, whoever is angry with his brother without cause shall be in danger of judgment. What kind of judgment? Whoever says to his brother, Raka. I don't know what translation is used, a Cuban translation maybe. You know what the word that means? When you said foolish, stupid. When you call a brother stupid, foolish, shall be in danger of the council. What's the council? The council in the Bible always talk about the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. When you see the scripture and you see the council of God, meaning the three personal Trinity coming together, and they decided that if you don't forgive, if I don't forgive, they will not forgive us. So the council, but whoever says you fool shall be in danger of just having a little heat on the earth while you're here. Read it. See, many of the church, even my church, don't believe that. What would be the judgment? Hell fire. There's people right now in hell because they refuse to forgive. Do not play around. Forgive. Love the people. Pastor, I can't. I'm hurt. His grace is sufficient. This morning, I want you to make a decision. You either going in that direction, heavens are closed. Finances continue. The lack of finances. Family. Death to the family, to marriage, because of unforgiveness. Or you choose to forgive and bring reconciliation, peace, harmony, unity. That's what the reason Jesus came, to die, to forgive us. I'm going to ask you today, how many here today say, Apostle, I do have unforgiveness. I do have bitterness. I was hurt unjustly or justly, or whatever case you're in now. And you say, Apostle, people owe me money. People hurt me. People betray me. That's not fair. Well, you are in a prison. You need to come out. I'm going to ask you today, how many people today sincerely say, Apostle, I want to forgive because I want God to forgive me. When I count to three, quickly, I want you to raise your hand. One, two, three. Say it with me if you're watching by the internet, by television. Say it with me. Father God, this morning, I can't hear you. Father God, say it with the heart. You can't forgive just with the mind. Say it out loud. Father God, today, I recognized that I have sinned against you. Right now, I recognize that I have unforgiveness, bitterness. I am angry. I am mad against people that hurt me. You need to say it louder. Father, if I've been hurt unjustly or justly, I forgive them all. They owe me, and I forgive them with all my heart. Release your grace for me to forgive. And right now, shout it. Right now, I make a decision. I make a decision to forgive with all my heart. Father, I forgive every person that hurt me, justly or unjustly. Right now, I release them. I release them. Lift your hands. I release them. Shout it. I release them. I let them go. And right now, I ask you, Lord, to forgive me all my debts. I am free. I renounce every spirit of bitterness, unforgiveness. Say it. Hate. Resentment. Right now, and I declare myself free. Father, heal my heart, heal my soul right now, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Stay tuned for Supernatural Testimonies.
¿Cuántas personas?
How many people?
En esta noche.
Tonight.
Tienen quistes, bolas, tumores en su cuerpo ahora mismo.
Have cysts, tumors, or growths in your body.
Yo no voy a orar, le voy a poner a usted.
I'm not going to pray, you're going to do it.
Póngase de pie,
stand.
Hija. Are you ready to use the name?
¿Estás listo para usar el nombre?
All the elders and men, Ephesians.
Todos los ancianos y los Efesios.
I'm going to tell the people to pray for the people.
Sí.
If you speak English,
si usted habla inglés,
run over here.
Venga para acá. Pray.
Go pray. Go for some pray. Begin to pray. Begin to
pray. Comience a orar.
A cyst on her ovary, and this young girl, the moment you gave the command, she prayed for her. She says, I feel the presence of God, and the cyst is no longer there.
Tell me, what did you feel?
I felt the presence of the Holy Spirit.
You got a cyst for how long?
For a year.
30 years. What did you do?
I just prayed for her in the name of Jesus to be healed, and then she got healed and started crying.
You need to celebrate the name of Jesus.
El nombre de Jesús.
For 6 years, she had this cyst in her ovaries, but tonight she got healed.
Yeah, I had a cyst in my ovaries since I was like 15 or 16 years old, and I would constantly kind of feel the pain. It was really painful, and it felt like it went from the front all the way to the back and out.
Tell me, what did you do?
I prayed like you taught us, and I commanded it out of her body.
You're praying what? In the name of Apostle Maldonado?
In the name of Jesus.
Come on!
I grew up without my parents, and I always had anger towards them and towards many other people. And 1 year ago, God spoke to me, and he told me that I have to love people unconditionally, just like he loves me. And as I started putting that into practice and showing people love and how much God loves them, people started coming to me, even my family members, my parents. They accepted Jesus over the phone. They go to the Catholic church, so they, you know, I prayed over them, and now, you know, I see a difference. I see how God's unconditional love, and I'm a channel, you know, showing God's love to them. I see how they are being delivered. Mm-hmm. And, you know, and they come to me and they tell me to pray for them. And I see how my whole family is being changed by God's love.
Because you forgave them.
I forgave them, yes.
Come on, Jesus.
And not just them, you know, I also want to say that, you know, I had many boyfriends in the past, and I always had unforgiveness towards them. And now I see how God have them call me, and now they are accepting Jesus, and I'm praying for them, and I forgave them. And I tell them, no matter what happened in the past, God loves you, and he has a great purpose and calling for your life. And I see how, you know, when we make a decision to walk in God's unconditional love, people will be delivered. Jesus is our role model, and he wants us to walk in God's love.
Come on, unconditional love. Lift your hand and say, thank you, Jesus.
Ella le diagnosticaron miopía y astigmatismo. No podía ver de lejos. El poder de Dios está sobre ella todavía. Ya comenzó a ver.
Cuenta, hija, ¿qué pasó?
Yo desde hace muchos años, desde que tengo 9 años, tengo miopía y astigmatismo.
¿Tenías?
Tenía.
Ajá.
Ahora puedo ver de lejos.
¿Qué sentiste?
Sentí como el poder de Dios me salvó. Oh.
To share your supernatural testimony, please write to us at 14100 Southwest 144th Avenue, Miami, Florida 33186, or email us at testimonies@kingjesusministry.org.
Can I pray for you, my friend? If you're watching, if you never received Jesus as your personal Savior, this is the moment that you can let Jesus come into your heart. I want you to repeat this prayer out loud, whatever place you're watching. If you're watching at home, if you're watching in your office, and then you're saying, Apostle, I feel lonely, I feel sad, I need Jesus. Repeat after me this prayer. Say with me, Father God, I recognize that I am a sinner. I repent of all my sins. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. Jesus, come into my heart right now. Amen and amen. If you did this prayer, please give us a call. And also, you can write me and let me know what Jesus has done in your life.
The central organ of the human body is the heart.
It's the heart.
Yet we humans have another heart, a spiritual one, that is the true center of our existence. Join Apostle Maldonado on a journey of discovery into the purpose, motivation, and potential of our spiritual heart. God wants us to understand how, in Christ, our heart is designed to pump life into our entire being, producing mental, emotional, and physical health. You were created to reflect the heart of our Heavenly Father, and God is ready to change our hearts to be like His through a supernatural transformation. Call now, and for your generous donation of any amount, we'll send you a copy of this life-changing book. Also, if you become a partner today, you will receive not only this book, but also a special DVD teaching and our exclusive partner pin. This is our way of saying thank you for your continued support to the ongoing work of our ministry. You're invited to the Supernatural Fivefold Ministry School. Bring your pastors, leaders, and staff members for 3 straight days of training, teaching, impartation, and activation in the supernatural power of God. With speakers, Apostle Rennie McLean.
Greater is He that's in you than he that's in the world.
Prophet Brian Carr.
Your speed is determined by what's chasing you.
Apostle Dwayne Swilly.
There is no institution on earth more powerful than the family.
Dr. Rodney Howard Brown.
We're going to dare to do some things that have never been done before.
And Apostle Guillermo Maldonado.
I want you to be comfortable doing miracles, signs, and wonders.
You will also receive a special prophetic impartation from Prophet Anna Maldonado, Prophet Marina McLean, and Prophet Kathy Lechner. You don't want to miss this 3-day event. Be inspired. Be transformed. Supernatural Fivefold Ministry School. Register now.
Thank you for watching today's program. If you want to learn more on how to accelerate and enable you to experience the supernatural in your life, contact us today. Join us next time as we see more of the supernatural now.
The previous program was paid for by the friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.